Peter, on the way, he lost to spend 10 minutes. A beautiful doll. Very clever. Could do lots of tricks. This is the vicar, the Reverend W.G. Burgess, coming out of the French windows at the old vicarage, throwing a stick for Peter. Good boy. And again. Now what's he got to do? Oh yes. Die for your country, Peter. That's a good dog. Yes. Down he goes. Up again. Now I'll throw the stick and the slipper and the newspaper. And I'll tell you which one to fetch. The slipper first. Now the newspaper. And now the stick. Clever dog. Now balance the stick on your nose. And walk with it. Oh, he didn't quite catch it that time. Try again. Yes, he got it. Good dog. This is the back lawn at the vicarage. I believe there's a bungalow built on this now. Going to have a race. Quite breezy. Bushes in the background are blowing. I think he's going to jump now. Over he goes. The happy children of Cheddleton and an accident which made them laugh. Find your own boys and girls. Find yourself if you can. I didn't realise there were so many children in Cheddleton School at that time. Peter's there with them all. Charlie and the baby that was lost. Here comes Charlie Chaplin again. I wonder where they got that old pram from. The baby's fallen out and Peter's coming and stealing it. Oh dear. Bring the baby back. Here he comes. Goodness me. Oh, give the baby some milk. He hasn't got much idea, has he? Dear, oh dear. Got the baby upside down. I think the idea was that Peter should steal the bottle of milk, but I don't think he likes the idea of picking the bottle up. No, he's not going to do that. Oh, that poor child. More milk. No, Peter doesn't want it. He doesn't want to know. The children are enjoying it anyway, watching with great interest. He did it again, but this time got caught, and now he is sorry. Oh, that pram. Goodness me. the baby's gone again. And who's this lady? Miss Clara Haynes, the village dressmaker. She made lots of wedding dresses and other things for ladies of the village, giving Charlie a good drubbing with the hand brush. And that's for letting the dog take the baby. Oh dear, what shall we do? He's got the milk bottle ready again. Ah, here he comes with the baby. Good dog. Well, at least he's got it the right way up this time. Put it in the pram. Off we go. Bye-bye, Clara. Bye-bye, Charlie. I think the children enjoyed that. All waving goodbye now, so I think the show must be over. A little break in between films, When We Were Young. This is quite a fashion parade, and it's a pity really that all the ladies wore these close-fitting hats, because you can't see their faces very well. However, you can notice that they were nearly all wearing the dresses with the dropped waistline, which was the real 20s fashion. Very few people without hats. Those look like shingled hair, those ladies have got. All strolling along, dressed in their best. Another little break. We're very fortunate to have these films of Cheddleton, you know. Mr. Burgess being helped onto the pole by Mr. Joe Nichols, the miller, and the other young man is Ron Kent. They are going to have a pillow fight. I wonder what's in those pillows. Goodness me, Mr. Burgess is in the drink. And here he is, swimming. I'm sure that water was awfully cold. And what on earth is he wearing? Good gracious, I think it's a football jersey and shorts. A very hardy man. Cricket. I think this is up at Ashcombe, I'm not sure. Too far away to recognise any of the players. But there is a close-up of one young man. Can anyone tell us who that is? He plays for Ashcombe Park because he's got AP on his cap. Shy smile. Now that's Mrs. Bowe, Phyllis Bowe, there. Just dancing back with the black bow on the front of her smock and the black hat on. This is the school country dancing team. Tripping the light fantastic with Bobby Barrett looking on. Keeping everybody in order. Mrs. Griffiths and Mrs. Bradbury there. And that's some of the Gaunt family dressed as gypsies. The dog's barking, making himself heard. They've finished dancing and Phil's just put a hand up to her face now. More village ladies with the children. And the man with the bottle, I think, is Jim Pegg, who lived on Chelton Heath. Mr. Hazeldine coming into the picture again. Do you recognise any of these ladies? There he is again with his bottle. Babies. What a fancy bonnet that is. Goodness me. Pudgy cheeks. Quite a good view of the weavers' cottages there. That man with his bottle again. Children being lifted up so that they can be on the picture. And here's Peter again doing his tricks. The three little girls in the background, you'll see a better shot of them in a minute, but the one in the centre is me, with two of my little friends. There we are. I'm just looking up now. Here comes the band, led by Mr. Jim Shenton. They haven't got any uniforms in this shot, but later on I think you'll see that they have got uniforms, so they must have saved the pennies. Percy Shenton beating the drum. Village boys, some of them wearing knickerbockers. And nearly all of them with those big floppy caps on. Shapeless dresses. Or as we call them, shifts today. Lots more carnival characters. I think this must be a different carnival to the other one that we saw. It looks like pirates again. Somebody on a cycle. And I think you'll see Mr. Burgess drive along in his Trojan soon. It's in the background there. More boys in knickerbockers. Clowns. Somebody in a tall hat. Here's the country dancing team again. Oh, close-ups of the children. And Peter, dying for his country again. Oh no, he's rolling over. I think he's getting a bit bored with it all. More shots of the band. Isn't this a lovely carriage and pair? We don't know who the lady is in it, but we think it might be Mrs. Ryder, who used to live at Basford Hurst, but we're not sure. Kiddies all looking suitably impressed. Being pushed forward to be on the screen. An old bus in the background there. Somebody wearing a fur. and such posh hats. Ah, now we're in the canal. I don't know whether we're supposed to be floating in these tubs, but obviously they're all filling with water. I think that young man that you can just see his head was Leslie Morris. That tub's gone spinning away. That's Ron Kent just gone out to get that tub. Don't rock the boat. It's surprising that they didn't all finish up in the canal. Tubs floating away. Now, that looks like George Bunting as a young man rescuing that tub. And you know, they look like the old-fashioned wash tubs that we used to have, the wooden ones. Now we're down on Cheddleton Sands, which was a little sandy beach behind the flint mill, dipping branches into the water and splashing everybody, with Peter and Mr. Burgess in the thick of it, of course. Another little break. When we were young, again.